Hello students, so we had learned about unification of Germany, unification of Italy. Today now we have to study about unification of Britain. You know that unification of Britain is also one of the important topic in nationalism in Europe. And here, before 18th century, Britain as a nation, it was not existing. Okay, so Britain like that one nation was not there before 18th century. It was inhabited by many inhabitants. Like people were mainly English people, Welsh, Scots, or Irish people. So it was inhabited by English, Welsh, Scots, or Irish people. And England was mainly England, one state, another one Scotland, and another one Ireland. Like that way, it was separated and Wales. These were separate, different states were there. And they wanted, English or England wanted to make it unified. Or they wanted to make a United Kingdom or England as a unification of England. So, when this unification in Italy, Germany spread, this reached in England also. And these inhabitants had their own culture, their own tradition. So their culture, their different language, their languages were different, their tradition was different, culture was different. And to unify these all together, that was not an easy task. So, but English people, they tried to unify. And English parliament, they wanted to make a unification, and English parliament has to be established. That is why English parliament, they possessed power from the monarch. So those who were as the monarch were ruling in this separate place, and English parliament made first England, they made a parliament and they had possessed the power from the monarch, and first they reached to Scotland. So first attempt they had done, England people they had done, they made their parliament and they possessed the power from the monarch and they reached to Scotland. But in Scotland, Act of Union was made, 1707, Act of Union was made, and according to that Act of Union, England had united Scotland. England united Scotland by the Act of Union of 1707. And when it was united with England, Scotland was united with England, English people, what they made? They made the language English as their common language, and Scottish language, Scotland people language was not a Gaelic language, which was forbidden, which was cancelled, which was abolished, and instead of that they said to follow English language. And they made their dress code, they made their own, everything same identity. So language was chosen as English language, Gaelic language was forbidden, and Scotland was united with England. So it was made in 1707, Act of Union. You understood? English Parliament. So here I have told you that England first started the unification of England. And in that first attempt did, that was English Parliament. They tried to get the power from the monarch, and with that they moved to Scotland, and 1707, Act of Union was made, and they joined Scotland with England. Next thing, they went to Ireland. Ireland was yet another place, yet another state. And here the Christianity was divided into two, namely Catholics and Protestants. In Ireland, Protestants of Ireland was under the dominance of the Catholics. So Catholics were more, and Catholics had dominated the Protestants in Ireland. That is why this Ireland and England, many Protestants. England was a predominantly Protestant one. So that when the Protestants of England, they helped the Protestants of Ireland to escape from the domination of the Catholics, Ireland joined with England. So here they played the politics of caste, or the Protestants, or the caste here. Okay, caste in the region, they took that idea for the unification. So Ireland, the Protestants, with the joining, the giving the side or giving support to the Protestants, in 1801 United Kingdom of UK was made. So, and they had made the national anthem that was known as even today. The national anthem was is God Save Our Noble King. God Save Our Noble King and the Noble King national anthem and the flag was made Union Jack. Union Jack as the flag and the national anthem God Save Our Noble King that they had made. This complete process of national unification of England was successful. So here England took the initiative to make the national unification of Scotland and Ireland. So first Scotland was joined with the 1707 Act of Union and Gaelic language was completely forbidden and Ireland was joined through the political method of Protestants, creating the sympathy of Protestants of Ireland and helped from the dominance of the Catholics. England gave the support for the Protestants. So, by this they have joined Ireland and complete United Kingdom was made. This was known as the unification of Great Britain or unification of England. Next thing we have to study, there were many allegories. Allegories means the abstract ideas they had used to unification. The abstract ideas are known as allegories. Allegories are mainly, for example, France used Maria as the French to imagine, to resemble or to, what we say, to develop or to create a sense of collective belonging. France used Maria as a female figure as representing French nation, France nation. Same way Germany used female figure known as Germania. For example, we will say India, we have Bharat Mata. India represents Bharat Mata, right now. So same way, these allegories, Bharat Mata is an allegory. We have learned in the nationalism in India. So same way, nationalism in Europe, the France used Marianne as the national, female figure to represent the nation of France and Germania to represent Germany. This Marianne, which represents the republic, democracy, and also the nationalism, nation, these all represent. And in that, we can say that red cap, tricolor flag in France, and also cockade on the head of this Marianne, cockade is given. These all have shown, these are representing the unity, republic, democracy, etc. in Marianne's cockade and the female figure. Same way, Germania has a Germania, that female figure or that female this goddess, which has a oak leaves which decorated on her hair. That oak leaves shows the heroism, and also which shows the bravery. So this way, many such imaginary figures were created by artists and painters that also represents the nation. So Germania and Maria, these two female figures were being created. Next thing we have to study about the Balkan crisis. So Balkan crisis we are going to study in detail.